Hi subscribers and viewers, I welcome you back to this wonderful channel. So I have this rogue access point Unifi AP AC light. The main problem about this device is whilst it was configured to provide access point services, it got to a point it became a rogue access point. You know, as users connecting to it could not browse the internet anymore because there was no DNS resolving. And so I decided to reset it severally. It didn't work. And then now the reset doesn't even work anymore. And the only option I have right now is to try and re-upload the firmware onto this device using a third-party software. So kindly sit back and watch me whilst I delve into this device, and I'll give you details on how I did the whole thing. Right, so I have my access point here, and I have my pin or a tiny broom here, and I'm going to put this access point into a reset mode. Right, if you put it into reset mode, there is a light in front of this access point here. Okay, there is, you see this light? Right, it's going to blink between blue and white, which means it's in reset mode. Then I'll proceed and launch the software and configure my AP to be connected to this access point, and then we get going with the configurations. Right, so let me quickly put it into the reset mode for all of us to see. So I'm putting the reset button is down here somewhere. So I'm going to insert this pin or broom into it, and then we'll get going. Okay, so I've currently pressed on the reset button. Let's see how things go. Right, so this is exactly what I meant. Right, you see the lights blinking between white and blue. Right, so this is exactly what I meant by putting this access point into reset mode. Now it's time for me to launch the software and then make sure I can upload the firmware. So now is the time for me to set the default IP of Unifi and then launch the software. Okay, so let me quickly set my IPs 192.168.1. Any number could be 20. No, this could be let me set this to 28, and then this will be 20. Okay, that's it. You don't set DNS, you leave it at default, and then you click OK. When you are done, now is the time for us to launch a software. I'll leave a link to the software below. Oh, I'm sorry. The name of the software is Pumpkin. So when you launch the software, click on put file. This window will appear and then you locate the firmware. When you click on the firmware, this will appear here, and then you put in the remote host IP, then click OK. So my access point is up now. You can see the blue light, which signifies the access point being up. Right. Have it online.